ਸਤਿ ਸ਼੍ਰੀ ਅਕਾਲ ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ, ਮੈਂ ਅਮਨਦੀਪ ਸਿੰਘ ਪਿਰਾਮਿਡ ਸਰਵਿਸਿਜ਼ ਦੇ ਹੈੱਡ ਆਫਿਸ ਤੋਂ ਇੱਕ ਵਾਰੀ ਫੇਰ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਨਾਲ ਲਾਈਵ ਹੋ ਰਿਹਾ ਹਾਂ। ਅੱਜ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਨਾਲ ਲਾਈਵ ਹੋਣ ਦਾ ਇੱਕ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਖਾਸ ਰੀਜ਼ਨ ਹੈ, ਜਿਵੇਂ ਕਿ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਸਾਰੇ ਜਾਣਦੇ ਹੋ। ਐਜ਼ ਯੂ ਆਲ ਨੋ ਦੈਟ ਵੀ ਆਰ ਟਰਾਇੰਗ ਟੂ ਮੇਕ ਸ਼ੋਰ ਦੈਟ ਡਿਊਰਿੰਗ ਦਿਸ ਟਾਈਮ ਵੈਨ ਦੇਰ ਇਜ਼ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਸੋ ਮਚ ਆਫ ਇਨਫੋਰਮੇਸ਼ਨ ਮੂਵਿੰਗ ਅਰਾਊਂਡ, ਗੈਟ ਟੂ ਹੀਅਰ ਦ ਰਾਈਟ ਇਨਫੋਰਮੇਸ਼ਨ ਫਰੋਮ ਦ ਰਾਈਟ ਪੀਪਲ। ਸੋ ਆਈ ਐਮ ਫੇਸਬੁੱਕ ਸੈਸ਼ਨ ਬਾਈ ਨਨ ਅਦਰ ਦੈਨ ਅ ਵੈਰੀ ਸਪੈਸ਼ਲ ਗੈਸਟ, ਮਿਸ ਸੋਨੀਆ ਟੱਕਰ, who works with Canadore College. Ma'am, I welcome you here on this Facebook Live. Thank you so much for joining in with us. And, you know, it's a great opportunity for our viewers to hear from you. First of all, ma'am, how are you doing? How are things with you? I hope you're keeping safe and sound.
Thank you so much, Aman, and thank you, Team Pyramid, for arranging this session. Aman, I'm doing fine, and we're working from home. It's just that... we just want this corona COVID-19 situation to get over, because it has changed a lot of things in our life, and we are just trying to stay positive, but things are not the same anymore.
Yeah, absolutely, things are not the same anymore, but like you said, we all are trying to stay positive. Ma'am, how are things at college? How everything is going on? I hope everything is in streamlined position.
So this has been a new situation for everyone, and everybody, nobody had an idea of something like this will ever happen. So college is also has kind of made a lot of decision to support students and their staff, and especially the focus is on international students, because they are kind of affected the most, because they contribute a lot to Canada and Canadian institutions, and they're still paying a lot of tuition and they can't travel. So that's the major issue. And hence, we are making sure that we support the students to the best of our abilities through online classes, by giving online classes at their convenient time. So we are also giving bursaries, so we will kind of discuss that, I think, over the period of this session. But I think so far, very good decisions have been made.
Yeah, that's great, ma'am. Absolutely, great decisions have been taken by the college for the students. Ma'am, before we get to that aspect of online classes, just wanted to, you know, we do have a lot of students who recently got their 12th scorecard, and also the students who graduated. So for them, if you could just brief us, you know, a bit about Canadore College, a bit about the location, and also the history of the college, that would really be great.
Sure. I think I'll just quickly give a brief presentation about Canadore College. I don't think I'll take more than 3-4 minutes. So Canadore College is a public institution in the province of Ontario in Canada. And we have 7 locations. So we have 3 campuses in the city of North Bay, which is 3 hours drive from Toronto. And we have Commerce Court, College Drive, and the Aviation Campus. And each of these campuses, they offer different programs. Then we also have 3 locations in Toronto. We have study locations in Scarborough, Mississauga, and Brampton, which are quite popular with the students from North India. The campus in North Bay is huge. It's a 650 acres campus. However, the study locations in Toronto, they would not have similar facilities like we offer at North Bay campus, in terms of a huge cafeteria or a library or maybe sports facilities. So students have to make the decision depending upon whether they're looking for these facilities or whether they're looking for location as the most important factor. So we are very upfront in explaining the difference about the campus and a study location. The North Bay, if I talk about as a city, is a quite a small city if we compare to the Asian standards or the Indian standards, because we are too many. However, the normal Canadian cities are like that. So it's a small community. Will give you a lot of Canadian experience. Students here are kind of interacting more with Canadian people. All the facilities of a good city are available in North Bay. as you will see in a metro city like Toronto, is just that the population will be less. You will not be seeing high-rise buildings, and otherwise you'll get a lot of Canadian exposure. Again, we have a lot of facilities. As I said, campus is huge with a lot of good infrastructure for students. This was the campuses that I talked about in North Bay, College Drive, Commerce Court, and Aviation Campus. I'll just quickly move to the programs that we offer at Canada College. So we have programs in aviation, skill trades, media and design, health and wellness, environmental studies, business. So we have around 80 plus full-time programs for students to choose from out of these areas. And the programs are 2 and 3 year diplomas, and they are 1 year graduate certificate programs. And I would say aviation and media are our flagship program because of excellent infrastructural facilities available for this program. So as I said, we have a separate campus on aviation and a lot of good graphic design, digital cinematography, acting for stage and screen, post-production kind of programs. The good thing about Canada is that we also open seats for international students for high demand programs like nursing and dental hygiene, respiratory therapy. It's just that the seats are very limited and the best profiles, they get the offer. We have a lot of programs in business accounting, business management, and supply chain management, healthcare admin, some of the most popular programs with students. As I was talking, that media is our flagship program. So Canada is the first college in Canada to actually be equipped with Dolby Atmos for re-recording and mixing and playback. So a lot of good infrastructure for media programs. About 93 films have been shot in North Bay in the past 4 years, and which kind of is about $100 million worth dollar films. We kind of do not offer co-op program, which is a lot of students ask about this question, which is a paid internship. But what we call at Canada is experiential learning. That is, a lot of programs offer the opportunity for students to learn by working in an organization for which they might or might not be paid. So for programs like strength and sports conditioning, recreation therapy, environmental management, there are a fixed number of hours that students have to work as part of the program. So we call it as experiential learning. We have about a lot of agreements with other universities. So if the students want to upgrade their diploma into a degree, they can transfer their credits and they can take advantage of the agreements that we have through which they can kind of get a degree after their diploma. We have a very beautiful Canada residence at North Bay campus, which is a 2-bedroom and a 4-bedroom layout. And for international students, the subsidized cost for this residence is around $500, whereas the domestic students, they pay around $800 to $900 per month. It offers a lot of privacy to the students if they really want to study well. I have seen a lot of students from off-campus accommodation shifting to college accommodation because it provides more security. It gives you a separate room, you have more privacy. So a lot of facilities, and I always suggest students to at least go for college residence for the first semester. We have a lot of clubs. We have an Indian club, hockey, basketball. The Indian students have also started a cricket club there. So a lot of sports facilities available there. Now we come to the key performance indicators, which is available for every institution. If we talk about colleges in Canada, it is available on their website as well. So it kind of talks about how well the a college or an institution is performing. So if we talk about the graduate employment rate, it's around 90%, which is indicative of the fact that students are getting jobs within 6 months of graduating from Canada or college. And I would suggest all the students to check these KPIs before making their decision about any institution. I'll just quickly give you a few of examples of our alumni who are doing well. So we have Jacob from India, and he is doing well in his career, is working as a Fairmont Hotel in Quebec. We have a student, Manoj, who is working as a recreation therapist at a company called Water Edge in North Bay. We have a student, Vasudev, who is working in a company called Voyager Aerotech in North Bay. and a student who has done project management IT and is working with Ministry of Government and Consumer Services in North Bay. Just quick examples. And our admission process is quite simple. We need all the academic documents starting from your grade 10 up to your latest qualification, your passport, work ex, and you're good to apply and contact Pyramidy Services for that, and we will process your application. As of now, we are not charging any application fee, but that will be applicable very soon, $100 Canadian application fee. We were planning to introduce it last week, but somehow it will take a few more days and students will have to pay an application fee. So that was the end of my presentation. So I hope it gave a quick, brief idea about Canadore College.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much for sharing about the college. Absolutely gives an understanding about the location, the programs and other, you know, aspects such as some of the unique selling points of Canadore College. Ma'am, but if you could just pinpoint the fee structure as well, if you can talk about the fee structure for the different programs and from the, you know, keeping the pandemic aside, in a general mode, what are the scholarship opportunities for the students as well?
So if I talk about the fee structure, it's quite affordable and it's less than what other Canadian institutions are charging. So the average fees is around $14,000 per year, which is approximately $2,000 less than what students will pay at other institutions. And it's a public institution funded by the provincial government. So there is no doubt about the quality of the program. So if the students are looking at an equal good education at a lower cost, then Canadore makes a perfect choice. And but there will be certain programs like aviation or I would say nursing, wherein the fees would be around 17 and 18,000 Canadian dollars. So program wise, the fee would differ. On an average, it's 14,000. And if I talk about scholarship opportunities for the students who are enrolling for September 2020, that is fall 2020 classes, they will be getting a bursary of 1,300 Canadian dollars from Canadore College. This is for North Bay campus. Since our tuition fee is on a lower end, we do not offer scholarships based on academics and IELTS.
Absolutely, ma'am. Absolutely, I agree that the fee is really, you know, on the lower end, and the programs and the quality is absolutely competitive as per the international standards. Ma'am, talking about the elephant in the room, which we, you know, touched a bit, is the pandemic and how it has impacted, you know, everybody, every single individual across the globe, and specifically our industry has been the on the receiving end big time. So there is a lot of confusion. There is a lot of, you know, information which is moving around and everybody is confused, like what's happening, what to do and what not to do. So where does Canadore College stands in this? What is the mindset of the college in this situation?
We are quite aware that this has kind of affected all the institutions, and we are trying to make equally good decisions to support the students. And we have made those decisions and we have even communicated those as well. If I talk about the fall 2020 intake in specific, which is kind of starting in first week of September, and it's just there. So we have offered students online classes. So as you're aware that last month IRCC announced about the two-stage approval process. So if students have who have received their AIP, and many of them have received in past few days, they're most welcome to register with us for online classes. Many of them have also started registering because we have shared the registration details with students, and students are quite excited about online classes. Majority of the programs are remote delivery programs, except for a few programs, for example, mechanical engineering or aviation. You cannot offer these programs online. And so they are hybrid programs wherein students have to be on campus for these programs. So we have supported students with that. We have also started issuing travel letters to students who have their study visas prior or on March 18th. So if students have the opportunity to fly, they can, as long as they can convince the CBSE official that their travel is essential. So we have started giving support letters. We have given online classes. And the best part about our online classes is that we know it's a lot of time difference. Their time gap is huge and students will be studying during their night time. So we will be offering our online classes for our Toronto campuses from 5:30 to 8:30 for Indian students, which will be their evening time. It will not be that they're sitting at night and studying that. So that's the best support that we give to our students so that they can attend it during evening. And also, as I said, for North Bay campus, students will be getting a bursary of $1,300 Canadian if they register for online classes for North Bay campus. So as of now, these are the decisions that college has made to support the students. Even at our North Bay campus, we have set aside a residence building for quarantine support of the students. And we will be charging a very minimal, rate, which is $20 Canadian per night for the students, and so that they can have their 14 days of quarantine without any difficulty.
That's great, ma'am. That's actually a very important news that you have shared. So all the viewers who are watching us, if in case you have any question to, ask, you can put it in the comment section. Sometimes it is a little difficult to answer the questions during a live, but we have our team sitting with us who will be able to answer your questions as quickly as possible in the comment section. So ma'am, moving ahead, all the points that you mentioned are going to be a great help, but ma'am, keeping the stage one, stage two process in mind, and also the whole pandemic scenario in mind, the families, the parents are quite concerned while they are deciding to pay the fee. And an important aspect, that is the refund process. So, this is something which parents really want to know. So during this pandemic, has Canadore College brought any change in the refund policy? Let's say if a student gets a stage one approval, but though we are confident, but being realistic, if there is a situation of a refusal and student has attended classes in this after the stage one in September, so how would college support the student? Could you help our viewers to know that?
So Aman, we have not made any change to our refund policy. So if a student receives refusal after AIP, and since it's a visa refusal, the 300 admin fee that we have been deducting, that's our refund policy for years now. The same refund policy will be applicable. So we are doing another this thing by supporting students by not making any deduction of tuition fee. So it will only be 300 Canadian admin fee. That is our usual refund policy.
That's great. That's great. So that's another help that the college is providing, ma'am. So, not taking your more time, I completely understand that you have a very busy schedule, and we really appreciate you joining us for this session. So before calling it a day, one last question, or I should say one last request. Any parting advice for the students and the viewers who are listening to us, who are watching us?
I would just request students that I understand that you're anxious. The parents are also equally anxious. All I want to say is that if you really want to start your studies in Canada, this is the best time to enroll for online classes, because Canadian government, IRCC, as well as your colleges, they are supporting you so much with so much flexibility. So why not take advantage of that flexibility? And whenever travel restrictions are removed and things are fine, you're like ready to fly. So just take advantage of this opportunity to study from the comfort of your homes. And that's what I will say. And just stay positive, and we are hopeful things will change soon.
Absolutely, ma'am. Let's hope that the things change soon. And on that note, I thank you for joining us for this session. And to all the viewers, if you have any other query about the college, if you want to know any other detail about the college, you can contact Pyramid East Services at the nearby offices of your hometown. And if in case you don't plan to visit, you can contact us on the number that is shared below. Our experts will make sure that they help you out as soon as possible. And if you are planning to visit, let me share with you that we are making sure that all the norms set by the central and state government are followed out by Pyramid E-Services. Social distancing, keeping the offices clean, sanitizers being placed at the office, and also appointment-based interaction is there, which makes sure that there is not too much crowd in the office. So if you have any question, you can make a visit and you can make a call to us. So on that note, ma'am, thank you so much again for joining us for this session. It has really been a productive and informative session. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Aman, for the opportunity and Pyramid E-Services for arranging the session. Thank you.
Pyramid, visa for a better life.